Some people are going to have that plan in their head. That's great, because if you practice your problem solving and experience a whole lot of it, then yeah, some questions you're just going to be able to look at them and you say to yourself, yep, I know this, I need to do this, I need to do this, I need to do this, there is the answer. That's what experience gives you, and we all have experience in many aspects of our lives, so we know what we're talking about. You get good enough where you say, yep, this is how it's going to be done. Then, that's great. But until you get there, why don't you write down the plan? Start thinking about the bits and pieces, because when you see these plans, after you look at problems, you're going to see there are bits and pieces that match up. There always seem to be bits and pieces that seem to happen in all types of problems involving gases, let's say. And that's where you're gaining that experience. So write down the plan. If you write it down, it doesn't have to be so detailed. Again, it's just about communicating. I want to do this, I want to do this, I want to do this. So I create a flow chart. If I was solving this temperature problem, it would be, well, I need to identify the conversion equation. I've got a temperature in Celsius. How do I connect that to Kelvin? Well, I know there's an equation. I might need to look it up. But once I've got the equation, I'll throw the numbers in and I'll solve the question. Now, based on my flowchart, I think I've got everything I need. There's no other information I need other than what's that conversion equation. So there we go. But in later problems, you're going to have to calculate or look up other information to solve problems. You're going to need a molar mass to convert something back into grams at the end of the problem, because you have to solve the problem in moles. So, if you need to look up or calculate info, your experience is eventually going to tell you, look, there's probably going to be some smaller chemist toolbox kind of sub-problems to solve, so build it into your plan. If you're ever stuck in a problem, considering that there's either data that you need to look up somewhere or calculate from a smaller calculation, because something ultimately could be missing from the plan. Here we have figure 4.11 from the OpenStax Chemistry 2nd edition under the Creative Commons license. This is really showing you kind of what I call the chemist toolbox. These kind of smaller calculations where you see the kind of connections with arrows, these are going to be common bits and pieces either at the beginning or the end of a lot of problem solving. Well, here's a gas. I can use that gas law to figure out a number of moles, but ultimately they wanted me to say what is the mass of that, so I'm going to need to know the molar mass of the gas. I might need to calculate that from the periodic table. These kind of calculations you're going to be relying on a lot, and so if you're not comfortable with these, go back and do some review again. So here we solve our problems. I've identified my conversion equation. We've got it on the top here. Then we substitute in that data, that child's temperature, 40.00 degrees Celsius. Oh, look, I see some units canceling out here, degrees Celsius, degrees Celsius. I then effectively add 273.15 to the 40.00 degrees Celsius, and I got 313.15 Kelvin as units. And I can summarize that. The child's temperature is 313.15 Kelvin. That's the answer to the question. And people have seen how I did it, and they've heard me say, this is what it is. This is the effective way to communicate some problem solving.